Hey, welcome to another edition of Outrageous Outdoors TV. We're headed to South Africa. South Africa. We're going on a safari with De Klerk Safaris. We're going to end up right here, Johannesburg, South Africa. We're going to go after a ton of animals. Outrageous Outdoors TV. First good shot because they're really tough.
Oh man, this is awesome. What a beautiful red hartebeest.
Welcome to Outrageous Outdoors TV. We're with De Klerk Safaris in the Kalahari Desert.
For the next several weeks, you're gonna see scenery galore, some of the most fabulous wildlife, and 14 animals killed.
So if you've ever wanted to go on a trip of a lifetime, just follow us, Outrageous Outdoors TV. So we're at the shooting range. We're gonna sight in a little bit, make sure our guns are still on for the long trip, and then we're gonna get out and do some hunting. We're pretty excited. Even just sitting here sighting in the gun is tough. We wanna be out in the woods right now, so.
We're gonna be sighting in on kudu.
Yeah, exactly. It's hot here. Back in Oregon, it reminds me of when we were in South Africa.
Yeah, it's even hotter here though.
It is hot today. You know, I'll tell you what an awesome opportunity. After we got done with the shooting range, we go out in the field and we start seeing animals, like right now.
We're not 200 yards from the camp, I think, and we start seeing animals. We get on a big herd of blesbuck. We'd never seen blesbuck in our life.
We're asking, so what is that? What is that? You know, and it says, those are blesbuck. And we look through, I don't think there was any males, just all females.
Right. Yep.
And then shortly after that, we saw that great, big, huge impala.
Nice
that
impala.
That was awesome. But he wouldn't stick around to give
Never
us a
shot. Never even got close to him. The springbuck was very similar. We saw the springbuck from 1,000 yards out that you ended up taking.
Oh, man.
But we followed him around forever in these huge 1,000-yard openings, and he was not getting close.
And we'd get close enough to where we think we'd get a shot, and he'd take off running again.
Yep.
Pretty typical of the South African animals.
Yep. But you'll see, we got on him.
Yeah.
And Jerry made an awesome shot that you are not going to want to miss. Watch closely that springbuck when Jerry hits him.
He sets up in the bush and we think we're going to get him. He's going to come to the left, but then he takes off running and here's what happens.
Oh, he took off.
He's going straight away. He might come out in the front. Just follow him, he might stop again. Try that elk call. Okay, he's gonna stop. Okay, on the shoulder.
Oh, capping, swinging over, buddy.
Oh, Betty!
Yeah!
Oh,
nice shot!
Yes!
Woo-hoo! Good shot. 260.
260 yards.
Yep.
Is he a good spring buck?
He's a nice one. In the record book.
Really?
Yeah.
My first African animal. Looks like I'm going to be somewhere in the record book, maybe. Johannes is saying. What do you think about that, buddy?
I love it.
Way to go.
Oh, man.
Well, we've been driving around for what now? How about, 3 or 4 hours?
Yeah, it's 11:30. We've been doing a lot of looking.
We've seen some blesbucks, some elands, and kudus, and we couldn't get anything to stop it.
Gemsbok.
Finally, we got
we've seen everything.
Okay, the way you measure a springbuck is you start right down here at the front, then you measure all the way up the front, and you keep the tape on the front surface, right up to the tip here. So you add both horn lengths and the circumference of both horns.
And where does this one rank compared to
this one?
This one will
go in the ECI record book. This one is probably 13 inches long, so 12 is about the minimum for the record book.
Nice.
This one is about an inch already into the book. And it's got nice heavy bases, so this will score well.
Hey, you are watching Outrageous Outdoors TV in South Africa, the Kalahari Desert. We'll be right back.
Okay, we just spotted a zebra. We're trying to sneak in on him. This is one of the animals the dude wants to take. We just got a little bit farther. He's about 200 yards out. We're gonna try to get as close as we can. Make sure we get one first good shot because they're really tough. He's coming around. You hit him. You hit him hard that time. He stopped. Reload, buddy. Okay, we just got a zebra. He hit him really hard. He didn't go very far. He hit him really hard. We had to sneak about, I don't know, 200-300 yards. Nice shot, dude. That was an awesome shot. He hit him the first time, I think. And then he started running, and he had to take a running shot, and man, he nailed him. Spun him around, he slowed way down, and I think I seen him drop. We're not far away, though. We gotta get on him. Hans, tell us a little bit about how you tell this is a great big old stallion.
Well, first of all, you look at what's between his legs.
That's right.
The stallion's got bigger mane. Uh-huh. The mane stands up, and when a zebra runs away from you, a stallion's got a very narrow piece of black between his legs, where the female's got a little wider black. So it's very difficult to distinguish a male from a female.
Right.
But if you look at the mane, and if you're lucky enough to get an angle between his, to look between his legs,
right,
you can see it's a stallion. Or running away, you look at the narrow black stripe.
From that's a bad time to find out that it was a stallion when it's running away. Huh?
Now, every zebra has different stripes, right? That's how they tell them each other apart.
It's like a fingerprint. Every zebra's got a different stripe pattern.
That's great. And then, what do you think about this one? How is it striped?
A big stallion and beautiful pattern. Not many bite marks. He's got a lot of character.
Do they get bite marks from fighting with each other?
And the stallions fight a lot.
Very good.
Yeah.
Well, thanks
awesome.
A lot, Hans DeClaire.
Yeah,
well done.
Okay, so dude, tell us a little bit about what happened. I mean, we couldn't even get much on film because it's so brushy.
Yeah, it was tough to see, and that's why we kept crawling on the ground, trying to get closer to get a better shot, because every time we found a spot and had a look, the brush was just so thick I couldn't get a shot off, and we kept crawling ways and look and crawling, and then finally I had a shot, but the only shot I had was from about the shoulder up, and took that shot, and he spun and went and fought and out in the field, and I shot a couple more times, and there he is.
He dumped beautiful. Him too, but I mean, you got a great shot right through the lungs.
Yeah.
Man, it was amazing. Joe had a bird's eye view on top of the truck.
I was in the rack in the trees truck. Here. Was sweet. I could see you and the animal. I saw him. He spun, man, when you hit him, and took off. What was he? Maybe 150 yards further out that he went.
Yeah, probably and 150 then, yards at the most.
And he then, turned and you could tell you'd hit him because all of a sudden he didn't want to run anymore. And then you hit him and boom, he dropped like a rock on that last shot. That
and it's a beautiful stallion. I mean, this is incredible markings on the back. And just really big animal. I'm really proud of you, dude. That was incredible.
Good,
dude.
Oh, that was a good time. It's so much fun. I can't even imagine. It just doesn't seem real. It's not sinking in yet for sure.
He shot a zebra.
You know what the amazing thing is that we thought the best part of the trip was just getting here.
Yeah, I know.
Now here we are taking animals finally.
This is the icing on the cake.
It really is.
Icing on the cake.
This is incredible. Well, this is just another great adventure at Outrageous Outdoors TV with Hans DeKlerk and DeKlerk Safaris. Yep. Thank you so much,
Thanks, Hans.
And we really appreciate the opportunity to be here in South Africa with Hans DeKlerk.
For an adventure of a lifetime.
If you ever wanted to go on an awesome safari,
DeKlerk Safaris in South Africa is the place you want to go.
This is the happiest place on earth.
Oh, sweet. That's killer.
Oh my, did you see that jump?
This is wild. South Africa, unbelievable.
I couldn't ask for a better trip.
DeKlerk Safaris is unbelievable.
There's nothing like it.
What an amazing trip. Hans, DeKlerk Safaris is the bomb.
I can't say enough. Cannot say enough.
Started hunting in 1986. I first worked for another safari company, which belonged to my uncle. And then in 1990, I started my own business. And in 92, I went over to America for the first time, started doing the shows there. And after that, we never looked back.
Hans DeKlerk knows exactly what he's doing. He's gonna put you on the animals. He's gonna mark those things off your list. And here's the funny thing about us. We had this checklist of all the animals we'd like to take. But as you get out there and you start seeing one species after the next, it starts to change your mind a little bit. You end up taking animals you didn't expect, and you end up getting things that you never would have dreamed of.
The family atmosphere, the amount of animals that are here on just this ranch, we haven't even been to the second ranch yet. You can't even hardly explain it to somebody.
What they'd expect is first-rate service. I mean, it's phenomenal. From the food that Marie prepares for us, three meals a day, down to just the place where we're staying at, the rooms, the service, and the little things, the fire pit, fires, you know, in the morning and in the evening to sit by to eat your breakfast or dinner.
What a day, Hans, huh?
Yeah, we had a wonderful day.
That was incredible. I mean, just every single step of the way, we just got one animal after the next. That was something, wasn't it?
It is unbelievable. I've never been in a place where every time I turn a corner, every time I walk around a bush, there's an animal that I have a choice right now. Do I want to harvest that animal or do I want to let it go? And it's exciting.
So the recommendation I would make to someone if I were to, you know, say come to South Africa first off would be there's nothing to compare it to in the States is the amount of animals that you can take. And if I were to recommend DeKlerk, you can see it on the video. We are just having such an awesome time here. It's just a blast.
Man, DeKlerk's is everything we expected to be and much more.
Way more.
You know, you can see on our little promo that we do for them on this video series, these guys are top-notch, first-class, the best pro hunters I have ever seen around.
They went head and shoulders, though, beyond the hunting.
Oh, absolutely.
The experience, the relationships, they were indescribable.
The
they
food,
were awesome.
The service, I mean, everything was five-star. It was unreal. I felt a little guilty for being out on safari.
Yeah.
I should have had my wife and kids. It felt like we were at a resort. It was
my wife says we were roughing it when
she
sees those pictures.
Absolutely.
That's definitely sarcasm.
And then what happens next?
is we're over in the other ranch, and you get to take your first animal. What a beautiful animal it was. It was incredible. It happened so fast that we didn't even have a chance to turn the camera on. I mean, it was like, there's the animal. Yep. Okay, Joe, take it. Hans is going, Joey, you must shoot, you must shoot, you know, in his little South African accent, which is awesome to be around. And he's going, there it is, there it is.
Yep, he was right there.
Beautiful, yep. Beautiful rams inside the bushes.
The anxiety of taking your first South African animal is, it's like your first buck. Yeah. I can remember when I was 13-year-old and took my first one. I was shaking.
The first one ever.
I was breathing heavy. Oh, yeah. And it did. It happened so quick. Dan didn't even get on it with the camera. But they were three of them. They were mingling around. And that guy turned and quartered right towards us. Hans said, take him. And I had my opportunity. And I did. And he went down so fast. The camera wouldn't have mattered as far as I'm concerned. I didn't see him go down. I thought he ran off because he went down so quick.
I had some really quality optics up looking through them, and it was like having it right in my bedroom. I mean, I could see it. And this animal turns. It looks at you like, what are you guys doing here? And all of a sudden, pow, I hear the pop, and he doesn't even take a step.
Lights
doesn't
out.
Doesn't move his head. Lights out. He's on the ground.
Out.
You made a perfect shot, brother. A perfect shot.
And that may have been my favorite animal of the trip, too. That is that's a crazy horned animal, that red heartbeast, as you will see.
Well,
hey, man. We just
one
dumped
shot,
him.
Dropped him in his tracks.
It's a red heartbeast. Really nice boy.
What a pretty animal.
Man, he's a nice one.
Is it?
Well done.
Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you.
Nice job. Thanks, Hans. Another great trophy from him, Declerc.
Oh man, look at those horns. That is a great horn.
He is thick, man.
He's fat.
That's a big animal. Oh, nice job.
That was beautiful. You stopped perfect. And he turned and you said, take him right behind the crease. And he turned and I just, look at that.
Perfect
that
shot.
Couldn't be more where I was aiming, right in front of the shoulder.
Yep.
That's
perfect. What a great animal.
Yeah. Awesome. Two animals down this morning. We got a zebra and a red hartebeest, 1140.
1140 already, we got two good trophies down, a really nice stallion zebra, and a great bull that's gonna be in the SCI book. Nice job, Joe.
Passed on a kudu earlier.
That's nice.
Lots of animals. Great. Oh man, this is awesome. What a beautiful red hartebeest. See how heavy his horns are? 22 inch on, you figure? About 22 inches in length. We hadn't seen too many of these. Never seen one up close, certainly. I mean,
except
what,
for
just
that
a beautiful
one small
animal
yesterday, but man, this
exactly.
And Hans picked out, there's two of them, picked out the bigger bull, and man, it happened fast. I mean, we didn't even
really
have time
fast.
To think. The animals were there. And
they were kind of skittish, and they were back in this brush that you see here, and Hans called out what the bigger bull was. He was broadside to us. He kind of turned, and he was facing us, and as Hans told us, if they're quartering towards you, take them right in front of the shoulder blade. You can't see it, but there's a hole right in front of the shoulder blade. I'm
well,
pretty
tell you what,
myself.
You know, it's pretty cool. The first animal I take is a spring buck, an SCI buck, and then the first animal you take is this nice red hartebeest bull, and he's going to be in the SCI record
which
book.
Is really exciting.
Pretty incredible, man. What a great
really
hunt.
Exciting.
Hans Declerc and Declerc Safaris. This has been just unreal.
It has,
I mean,
man.
This is just a beautiful
this
animal.
Is a trip of a lifetime.
I love how these horns just bend back like
go
that.
Right up.
What a beautiful animal.
He's
nice
pretty.
Job.
He's pretty.
So tell me, how does it feel? You know, your first
shot. You don't have the first
animal.
Shot, Dan. You have that. It's kind of like buck fever, you know. You're waiting to get that first one under the belt. So when I pulled the trigger, it just felt perfect. And I didn't get to see him go down, but Jerry said
well,
he dropped
you,
in his tracks.
I just heard a whack, just a whack. I knew you hit him hard, and he just dropped right in his tracks.
That's
he expired in like 2 seconds. He was done. So
oh, I'm thrilled.
What a great
Dan
deal.
Didn't get it. It was kind of a quick scenario. We didn't get it on the camera, unfortunately, but you're seeing it right here, and you're hearing the story. It was awesome. The Declerc Safaris again just did an awesome job. For
nice
us
great
here.
Job. Well, it's the end of day two, and we were looking for that great big kudu buck, but we never did find him. We did find him along
day.
The way, though, a couple nice animals, and
we did.
Dude had got awesome a zebra, day. Which was amazing because that's the only zebra we saw all day long.
True. And good point.
Yeah. We saw a couple other good red hartebeest, but yours by far was probably the nicest one we saw. So
I'm real happy with
man,
it.
Man, what a great day.
You it know, was a good
two
day.
Two good animals, and tomorrow we get to go out and start it all over again.
We keep getting to take more and more animals. It's awesome out here.
You know, as you journey through life, you might happen to walk for miles and miles through your life, and days go by, and you're not really sure what life really means.
And sometimes in that life, you start to build up a wall for protection, really. It's like this fence here. This fence represents protection. It keeps the cattle in and keeps the predators out. In life, we do the same thing. We build up a wall, a fence, just like this one. Sometimes it's a fence that we build up to make sure that other people don't abuse us, or maybe it's just so that you don't feel stupid, or maybe you just don't want to look bad in front of other people. But I'll tell you what, when you build up this wall, it separates you from one thing, and that's your relationship with Jesus. You see, that the Bible's real simple when it says this. It says, anyone who believes in him shall be saved and shall not perish. And I'll tell you what, the only way to know that that's going to happen in your life is if you tear down the fence, if you tear down the wall. The wall separates you and Jesus. And I'll tell you what, maybe you didn't even understand that you built one up. The Bible also says that you're either for me or you're against me. So there's no in between. It's like this fence. If I got on top of this fence and walked down it, I would fall either on one side or the other. It's the same with your relationship with Jesus. You can't be on one side or the other side of the fence. You can't be on top. You have to choose one side or the other. I'll tell you what, in my life, there's been many times that I built up a wall or a fence. And with my team, Outrageous Outdoors, if there's ever a wall between us and Jesus, we stop, we pray, and we ask the Lord to tear it down. We can't do it on our own because we're not strong enough or courageous enough. But with the love of Jesus, we can tear down that fence. We can tear down that wall and have a relationship with him. Remember what it said, anyone who believes in me shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Would you take some time with me today? Would you be willing to tear down a fence, tear down a wall, and accept Jesus in your heart? I guarantee you, what's on the other side is way better than what you've been living in. It's gonna bring you peace. It's gonna bring you joy. It's gonna bring you happiness. Are you willing to take that step to tear down this fence? Are you willing to take that step to tear down the wall in your life? If you are, would you pray with me? It's real simple. It's like this. Dear Jesus, come into my heart. Be my Lord and Savior. Help me remove the wall and the fence that I've built up between you and I. I know I can't serve two masters. I can't be on one side and on the other. I've got to choose. So I'm choosing you today, Lord. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. Help me open up this fence of opportunity to have a life that's full of peace and full of joy. In the name of Jesus, amen. It's really simple to know him. He loves you very much. And today you might have built up a fence, but this is your first step in tearing it down. Hey, if you've prayed that prayer with me today, would you do me a favor? Log on to our webpage, Outrageous Outdoors TV. Let us know how God changed your life. If you leave your name and address, we'll send you a Bible so that you can start walking with the Lord. Hey, thanks for joining us at Outrageous Outdoors TV. We'll see you next time. We've been in the Kalahari Desert with the Clerk Safaris. We'll see you next week.
Okay, it's the morning of the first hunt. None of us can sleep. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. We woke up at about 3 and we can't sleep. My good friend that I brought with me, I'll never do that again. Dude Ayler wakes me up 3 o'clock in the morning, says, hey, get up, it's time to hunt. I look outside, it's pitch black. It's unbelievable. I see dead kudu. Oh, I see a dead wildebeest.